evening. It's so great to see you all. And it was great at 2 o'clock to walk out here for rehearsal and see the full orchestra in front of me. And then we watched every variety of weather that could possibly happen today happen. So it's great that it turned into a beautiful evening. It is a good thing for us to remember that we're thankful to be together, that today's the anniversary of D-Day, and that we're thankful that we have a great country to live in together and celebrate all of us. A great American who will play a piece of music by next is Duke Ellington. So sit back and enjoy this great medley.
We'll be right back.
I'm going to talk so I can dry off for a second. Wonderful medley of tunes by Duke Ellington. We were rehearsing very hard because some of us up here didn't learn those tunes in the original time that they were composed. And I said, some of the audience may have heard this at its premiere, so it's a joke. You can applaud and you can laugh. I know you're not used to it, so. We're gonna play Brahms' Hungarian Dance, number 5. If you like number 1 better, come back next year. Anybody here when that was first composed? Words? Okay. Now we're going to do a feature on our trumpet section called Bugler's Holiday by Leroy Anderson. But I have to tell you, his real name is Leroy. And his family's from Boston. They're very sensitive about this. So everybody say Leroy. That's right. Okay, you got it right. And I know this will embarrass him, but Joel Tillman, our principal trumpet player, just retired as an elementary or as a middle school band teacher, 34 years, right? 34 years. So imagine how many young people got to study music with the great Joel Tillman. He has never sounded better.
Except for that kid.
Thank you.
Well, one of the great things that I spent time on this year when we weren't having concerts was researching a lot of music. And there are a lot of composers and musicians whose work was underrated or neglected for reasons of race, gender, and a variety. So we've really committed ourselves to diversity and in our programming, and also looking into music that was left behind. I learned an interesting thing in doing some research. Who can tell me who wrote Singin' in the Rain? Anybody ever heard of Ignacio Brown? He's a Mexican-American who was a film composer who wrote Singin' in the Rain. So what a joy to find some things that we neglected to find because we're busy. All of us need to make time to recognize great people and sometimes those that we've left behind. So while the blood rushes back to the lips of the trumpet players, we're going to do a string feature on Singin' in the Rain. Thank you. So, I don't know if all of you know this, but there's a remake of West Side Story coming out. And according to my son, who is a movie buff, who memorizes the dates of movie releases, the current release date is December 10th. And Steven Spielberg is directing it. One of the things, a lot of times when a movie remake comes out, we talk about it at my house, do we need a remake of such a great movie? But it's fun to see a new take on some different action. We've seen this a lot because we hear different singers singing the music from West Side Story. So it's time for a trivia quiz. I'm gonna ask this lady right here in the sunglasses. Yeah, you, right, the one that just turns out. Who played Maria in the original West Side Story? Everybody together.
Carol Lawrence.
I meant the movie version. Carol Lawrence on stage, I believe, is that right? And Natalie Wood in the movie. Did Natalie Wood really sing?
No.
No.
Who was it?
Marnie Nixon.
You want to know about a great soprano who sang everybody's role, including the high notes for, who was in My Fair Lady?
Audrey
Hepburn. Marnie Nixon, look her up, great soprano. So, well, we're excited to play this great medley from West Side Story. Go rent the old movie, watch the new one, enjoy it, but the music is really hot.
Thank you.
So there's music education in everything that we do. So we need you guys to clap at certain parts of this song. But I want you to clap well. I want you to clap correctly. I want you to follow the dynamics that I give you. Dynamics are the loud and soft of music. Everybody say it after me. Dynamics are the loud and soft of music. You're going to be great.
Do I sell them more? Is that all they need to know? Not how to do it. One quiz per show. Percussion. We ready?
Was the Radetzky March by one of the Strauss guys. Which one?
Johann.
That was Johann?
Senior.
It was Johann Senior. Johann Junior was the real money maker. And then the grandpa also wrote great Strauss's waltzes. So we are so thrilled that you came out to be with us tonight. It's good for you to clap and move yourselves about. Helps aerate the sweat a little bit. We're going to close our program with a rousing number, which I think you'll recognize. You might clap along.
Thank you.
Philharmonic and Chamber Concerts for the fall. We've just got some dates released in our halls. Pay attention. We'll be back to see you. Come see us. Thank you.
One more round of applause, please, for the Oak Ridge Symphony Orchestra led by...